Hello makers, let's have a look at this little tiny sensor. I just have to zoom in so that you can see it. It's the APDS9960, and it's a functional sensor. It has three different modes. First of all, it's an proximity sensor. As you can see, there is a lens and an infrared LED. It works similar like this sensor. This is a very, very cheap sensor, and it doesn't measure distance, but it can detect when an object is in close proximity to the sensor. Well, even though it's quite tiny, I wouldn't pay that much for the sensor just to detect proximities, because this sensor costs about 5 euros. That's pretty much. But also, it can detect different colors, so you can build your own ambilight system around your TV with some of those sensors. But that's not the reason I bought this sensor. The third mode is it can detect gestures, simple gestures. If it really can do this, this would be worth every penny. Think about it, controlling something just with a wave of your hand. Let's try this. Okay, we are at the process of wiring, and look at that. It has a pin marked SCL and SDA. You know what this means. This one is an I2C module, so connecting it would be pretty routine. We're using what for this? First of all, ground. Because we need common ground. What a surprise. VCC. VIN. Well, this one runs on 3.3 volts. It has a voltage regulator though. This one looks like a voltage regulator. Let's see if I can check the numbers. Well, I can't identify the voltage regulator. Maybe if I would put a little more effort in it, I could, but let's hook it up to 3.3 volts. Won't hurt the sensor. SCL, SDA, you know the drill. SCL, the green line. Goes directly into analog 5. SDA, analog 4. Well, that's quite it. There's also an interrupt pin. Well, to use this sensor as a gesture sensor, you need this interrupt pin. And it must be an interrupt pin on the Arduino. Pin digital 2 is an interrupt pin on the Uno. Well, since this sensor was developed by SparkFun, you will find a very good library from SparkFun. I'm not sure if you can reach it from the library manager, but I'll leave a link to GitHub where you can find and install this library manually. And this is one of those examples that's delivered with it. First of all, we find the interrupt pin 2, that was the purple wire. We initialize the SparkFun APDS9960 sensor. We find the interrupt pin as an input, serial output as usual. Attach the interrupt to an interrupt routine. Interrupt routine is the name of the function. It's this one. Oops. And define if the pin is falling. That means it's pulled down to ground. It will stop everything it's doing and calling the interrupt routine. Initializing the sensor, which returns a true or false value, so you can see if the sensor reacts to your init command. And enable gesture sensor. As I said before, this sensor has three modes, and you cannot use all three modes at the same time. Would be pretty cool, but you can't. The looped function, the Arduino checks if the ERSR flag is set to 1, that does this interrupt routine. D is set to the interrupt handle gesture, so it calls a function called gesture. Reset this flag and reattach the interrupt. And here is all the magic. This sensor can detect 6 different gestures. If you wave your hand up, down, left, right, go near the sensor and move away from the sensor. And that's pretty much it. Want to see how it works? I start the serial monitor. So, the sensor is running. Let's try some tests. I'm moving my hand over the sensor from left to right. And now from right to left. This one works. From the bottom to the top. Well, didn't check again. And from the top to the bottom, from up to down, near and far away. Okay, again, yeah, not perfect, but it works. Let's see if you can do something cool with it. Well, guess what happens next? Probably nothing. Well, a little sensor with a big potential. Although it has often problems to detect the right gesture, it's a cool way to control something without the need to touch it. And if you buy it from China, you get those about 3 to 7 euros. But beware, I also bought a sensor with the same name. You can see it here, a little larger PCB. APDS 9960 RGB gesture. It even has the I2C address on it. But this seems to be the 9930 version, because as I tried it, it detects proximity and RGB colors, but it didn't detect any gestures. I wouldn't say every sensor that's in this size is really a fraud. But you probably have to buy several of those items from China if you want to have the correct one. Or you buy those sensors directly from Adafruit or Spark. The only thing that's missing is a cool project for this sensor. If you have some cool ideas, how can you leave a comment below. If you like this video, thumbs up, share, like, subscribe, do whatever you want. But be creative. Bye.